My name is George. I'm from Greece, and my name on HwBox is Astalavista. I've been studying computer engineer. I'm finishing my studies right now, and yeah, that's it. I'm working on retail. I began like 2003 to 2004, the Pentium 4 era, the first unlocked Pentium 4 processors. It was kind of weird back then, it was difficult. There were many parameters to search and find out what's best for it, but I ended up looking on the internet and mostly on magazines. And I ended up destroying a couple of motherboards back then. Yeah, but searching a little bit, but I eventually found out to do it, and I remember doing some nice scores out there. Okay, so my main motivation was to make my computer run faster. So I can do games faster, edit videos, which was difficult back then, faster. So yeah, that's it. I think the best highlight was in the Core era, the Core to Do's, where DDR2 and dual cores, if you overclock them, you got so much speed out of it. So I started searching, and mostly online, and I posted some nice scores back then. Overclocking today is much more easier. I mean, it's much more straightforward. You just get the unlocked processor and learn a couple of things like V-core and voltages and so many other things, but not that complicated just in the past. You just learn a few tricks, maybe on the hardware side, maybe on the software side, and you just try to push it as much as you can. I want overclocking in the future to be much more technical. I mean, I need to try hard, to try harder in order to be the best and the faster. I wish it could be an eSport. I wish it so people can gather around and like a championship, so whoever comes first wins the championship and the trophy and the fame and glory. So you are the faster overclocker, means you know a lot about tweaking and finding the most out of your computer. I believe it can be like a league. It's much more difficult because there must be a lot more competitors, but if there are people gathering around and talking about it and share the knowledge, maybe it's inevitable, it's inevitable. If I could change one thing, I think that there shouldn't be so much binning hardware. I think that all hardware should be the same and should be safe for everyone. So there are no, you know, favoritism over the good ones, over the overclockers and the bad ones. So I wish there were no golden CPUs. It's what makes the gap. I wish there were no golden CPUs, or there'd be so much gap between the best overclockers and the pro overclockers and the enthusiast one. I wish that gap should be a little bit closer, so you have a chance going from enthusiast to pro. So if you're a young overclocker and you want to learn things, you just go straight to the internet, straight to the HwBox. There are a lot of people that can help you around. You can try out a few things. There's cheap hardware that you can get and tweak it and find what you can do next. And, you know, just try things and the scores will come out, but you have to keep practicing. And practice and study and come close with much more experienced people. So it's my first time in Taiwan here. I saw very nice things. Of course, it was an excellent experience. I met so many people here, and I eventually had fun with the overclockers around here because there are so many good guys. And we're talking and sharing experience and learning a few things. It's quite nice.